have is the optional matching with the question mark. Okay, so the question mark will help us to match optionally. If it matches, fine. If it's not matching, then also it's fine. Okay, so sometimes there is a pattern that you want to match only optionally. Okay, that is, the regular expression should find a match whether or not that bit of text is there. Okay, so the question mark character flags the group that precedes it as an optional part of the pattern. Okay, so the question mark character flags the group that precedes it as an optional part of the pattern. For example, we have a code here, read.compile. Here the pattern is bat, woman, which is put in parenthesis, question mark, and then man. Okay, so this whatever is there, it is optional. Okay, so whatever the group that precedes the question mark is an optional part of that pattern. It might be there or if not be there. Okay, and it is put in parenthesis. Then bat regular expression dot search the adventure of Batman. Okay, so as it is there, it will return, it will say that it matches to the pattern. What matches to the pattern? Batman matches to the pattern. Okay, so that is sent to the move1.object. Move1.object will have a method known as group, and it will return the only text that is matching to the pattern, and that is Batman. Okay, now if you give Batwoman. Okay, so in the first one, it was not necessary that WO should get matched. Okay, so but WO was an optional part of the pattern. Okay, so next we have is bat regular expression dot search the adventure of Batwoman. So the adventure of Batwoman, which is there, MO2, then that Batwoman is already there in the string. So that will be returned to the match object. And what will group print? Group will print the one which is matching to that particular pattern of the regular expression. So what is there? Batwoman is matching. Okay. So next, what is there? Using the earlier phone number example. Okay, we had a phone number example with the 3-digit area code, then hyphen 3 digits, and then hyphen 4-digit code. So you can make the regular expression look for phone numbers that do or do not have an area code. So here the area code is optional. So question mark, that area code can be suffixed with the question mark. So anything prior to the question mark, preceding to the question mark, will be considered as optional. So in the phone number, we'll consider the area code as optional. That is the first 3-digit numbers. So then what you enter the code is enter the following into the interactive shell. We have a compile method which will create object, okay, of this particular expression. So what is used here? /d, which marks a digit, followed by a hyphen. So this thing is optional, okay, but it has to match to the rest. The rest is important. Okay, so phone regular expression dot search my number is, this thing is given here, all it will match. Okay, all it will match. So mo1.group will just return the text that is matching to the pattern. So it is correct here, it is matching to the entire pattern. But next, what is here? What you are giving? Search method my number is 555. You are not making use of the area code. So the next time, the next math object along with the group will just print the pattern which is matching, and it is not compulsory that it has to match to the area code, as you have kept the area code as optional by making use of the question mark symbol. So question mark symbol is used for optional marking in Python. Next we have is matching 0 or more with the star. Okay, so here you can make use of a star symbol with the regular expression. If you are making use of star symbol in the regular expression, it will match 0 or more. That means if that part of the text is there, fine. That means more than one source is there, fine. If it is not there also, it is fine. If you are using which symbol here? Asterisk symbol. We will come to know with the example. The group that precedes the star can occur any number of times in the text. Okay, so if I have a text, it and that pattern can occur any number of times in that text, then also it will match. Okay, so here zero or more means it can be completely absent or repeated over and over again. So completely absent also is fine. Getting repeated over and over again also it is fine. Then it will match with the text. Okay, so let us see an example. Read dot compile. The pattern, regular expression pattern given is bat, and in that parenthesis you have used so asterisk which is there. So any text prior to the asterisk means that this particular text or this particular text of that pattern can be completely absent or it can be repeated over and over again. Okay, so for the search method you are giving here which text, the which string, the adventures of Batman. So Batman is there, obviously W is not matched, so it is completely absent, zero or more. So zero matching it is, but Batman is there in the pattern, so it will return, the group method will return Batman. Okay, second condition, what is happening is the string passed is the adventures of Batwoman. The string passed is adventures of Batwoman. So W O and M A N is there, so it will match, so it will return Batwoman. So it is once, pattern matching is one because W O is appearing there once. But the next time, more than once also is possible. So the next string used is bat, where WOWO is repeated many times. So this also is okay when you are using asterisk. So it will say that it does exist and it will return the pattern which is matching. Okay, so what will happen if you are using asterisk is, if it is matching once, fine. If it is matching zero time also, so it's okay. And if it is matching many times also, it's fine. The next one we have is matching one or more with the plus. Okay, previously asterisk was zero or more. Here plus character is used for matching one or more. While asterisk means match zero or more, the plus means match one or more. That means that that pattern should appear at least once. Okay, so unlike the star, which does not require its group to appear in the matched string, the group preceding a plus must appear at least once. Okay, and it is not optional, and it should appear at least once. For example, the same example we'll be seeing. RE.compile, the pattern is bat wo plus man. So plus prior, whichever is there, that group should match in the string at least once. Okay, so search the adventures of Batwoman. Okay, so it will return to the string mo object 1. So mo object 1, what it will do is mo 1, it will be used with the group method. The group method will return the string that is matching with the pattern. So which one is matching here? Batwoman. Okay, so next string taken is the adventures of bat wwo, which is occurring many times. More than once also is okay. So mo dot group will get matched and group will return the one which is matching to that pattern. Okay, next we have is bat regular expression dot search, the adventures of Batman. Now wo is not there in the string, so when you take this object and when you compare it with none, it will be true because that search method will not return to that math object. Okay, it will not return a match object, so none means it will be true. So plus, any group which is preceded prior to the plus, that has to be matched one or more than once, but not zero. Next we have is matching specific repetitions with curly brackets. Okay, so curly brackets you can use for repeating a pattern this number of times. Okay, if you have a group that you want to repeat a specific number of times, follow the group in your regular expression with a number in curly brackets. That means if you want a pattern to in a group to repeat for several times in your regular expression, then follow that group with a number in curly brackets. For example, the regular expression okay, this ha which is there, that is followed by the number in curly brackets. So when you put a group is just followed by a number with curly brackets, then that regular expression will be repeated 3 times. So we'll match the string ha ha ha, okay, but it will not match ha ha because it is occurring only twice and it is repeated only twice. Here how it will be, it will compulsorily match 3. Okay, instead of one number you can specify a range by writing a minimum, a comma and a maximum in between the curly brackets. So instead of one number you can give 3 things to in the curly brackets. First thing is the minimum number, and second is comma and a maximum in the curly brackets. For example, the regular expression ha 3 comma 5 will match ha 3 times, 4 times and 5 times. That is, minimum is 3, maximum is 5 and in between the 4. Okay, so this also is allowed. You can also leave out the first or second number in the curly brackets to leave the minimum or maximum unbounded. That means first or the second number in the curly brackets, that is in the minimum and the maximum, you can keep it optional. The second or the first one is understood. That is, for example, ha 3 comma will match 3 or more instances of the ha group. That means minimum it should be 3 and more also is allowed. While ha of 5 will match 0 to 5 instances. Okay, minimum is 0 and 5 is the end. So 0 to 5 instances. Curly brackets can help make your regular expressions shorter. Okay, so curly brackets will help us what? It make our regular expressions shorter. These two regular expressions match identical patterns. For example, ha of 3 is same as ha repeated 3 times in 3 groups. Okay, same way, ha of 3 to 5 will be the same as the below, where ha is repeated 3 times, 4 times and 5 times. So instead of using such a big string, you can use a smaller regular expression. Okay, so let us see an example. The pattern matching they have given is ha 3 times. Okay, so you create a object, regular expression object, which is in ha regular expression. This regular expression object calls a method search, and it will search the string given for matching is ha ha ha, which is 3 times. So this will return a match object. The match object is again calls a group method. What group method will do is it will return the pattern which is matching. Pattern which is matching, and what is matching? Haha is matching. Okay. So next, what is given for search is ha is given. Okay, ha is given, but you cannot use it only once. It has to be repeated 3 times. So it will return a math object, and the math object is covered. Compared with none, then it will give it as true because ha is not used there one time. Okay, so this was about matching specific repetitions with curly brackets.